Hey, I wanted to see if I could make a quick video. I hope it's quick. I tend to ramble and stutter and takes up a little bit of time. But I wanted to see if I could make a quick video for Delbert out there. I wanted to try to explain your pitch curves and your throttle curves. That way you can take the suggestions that have been given to you and then you know, put the settings into your transmitter. Based off your videos, I think you've got a Spectrum DX6i. That was actually the radio that I started out with. Hey, I really like that radio. It works really well. But I was watching your hovering video the other day, Delbert, and you know I mentioned that you know just to me what I saw it looked like. You know, the helicopter was bobbing up and down, and you know I didn't know if maybe that was you. You know, I didn't know if you were overcompensating up and down, which is actually something I did a lot when I started. Now I'm certainly no pro. I certainly don't know it all. I'll certainly never claim that I know it all. But throughout the past couple of months, I've gained a lot of knowledge from. From guys like WC, Wicked Clown, George, and you know quite a few other guys, and I'm sure I'm missing out on naming them. But I'm absolutely done rambling. We're gonna go ahead and get on to your settings. I saw your video this morning. You showed your settings, and I think it's great that you did that because that way you can get. Help from other people. I did see your other video that you had your blades on the one was upside down. Okay, now having that one blade upside down, I'm just kind of blown away that it actually flew. That really surprised me. But as far as your bobbing, you know, the helicopter bobbing up and down, I think you're still going to get that. If you keep the settings that you've got, you know, after you turn that one blade the other way around, I still think you're going to get that bobbing because of the way your settings are set, or the way that your settings are. Now you've got, if you take a look at the settings in your radio, you've got a graph like this, where your pitch curve. Is linear like that, and then forget that line. There we go, and then your throttle curve is also linear because your pitch curve at the lowest point is at zero, and at the highest point is at 100. Okay, so this is your pitch curve, this is your throttle curve. Now you have your throttle curve also at zero, and your highest point at 100. So with your pitch curve linear like this, and your throttle curve linear like this, what this is going to do is no matter where your stick position is going to be, it's going to be even. Between your pitch curve and your throttle curve. So if you have you bring your throttle stick up to 50%. So you've got your 50% of your pitch, which actually should be level. Is that right? Yeah. And then your throttle, you'll be running at 50% throttle. Now, when you put your stick at 75 on both your pitch and your throttle, then you're moving from the 50% to 75% on both. So you're gaining pitch and you're gaining throttle at the same time. Now, when I first started flying my 500, my pitch curve and throttle curves were like this also. They were both linear. And I had a hell of a time trying to control it because as I would raise my stick up, I was gaining pitch and I was gaining throttle, so my helicopter would jump up. And then, okay, oh my gosh, my helicopter's going too high, so I would bring my stick down. Well, now I'm losing pitch and I'm losing throttle at the same time. And it was just, it was a very, very scary time for me because I'm trying to learn and I'm watching my expensive helicopter jump up and down like this, and I did not like it. And I actually just set it aside for a while because I couldn't handle it. Now I'm sure that there are a lot of people that have their throttle curves and pitch curves like this, and that's fine if it works for them. But for beginners like us, linear throttle curves and pitch curves are not the way to go in your regular normal flight mode when you're in position zero. It's just not good. Okay, so we'll get rid of this. Okay. Now, something I did do, I saw that WC Wicked Clown, he made some suggestions for the pitch and throttle curves, and I really like what he did because they were actually very similar to what I did, and I absolutely love the way that my throttle and pitch curves are set up now. Okay, what he is saying in normal mode, because I think in the one video that you did that I saw this morning, you said, you know, right now you're not flying in your stunt mode, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. It took me a long time to actually, flip that switch, for the idle up. Just go ahead and fly around in your regular normal mode. You're just hovering. That's all right. For your regular normal throttle curve, at your low position, have that at zero. At your 25%, you've got 30, okay, and then you've got 65. This is your throttle. So you got This will be your throttle curve. 0, 30. 65, 65, 65. This is at your low position, your 25 position, 50 position, your 75 position, and your high position. Now, what this is going to give you is that starting at your low position, you'll have zero, so you've got no throttle. At your 25%, you've got 30% throttle, which will that'll get the blade spinning for you. Then when you get to 50%, 75%, and 100% on your stick, you're only going to be flying at 65% throttle. That will give you good solid throttle to, that way you can play around at that same throttle. And then what you're going to do over here, this will be your pitch curve. If I could spell, here we go. Let me get rid of that. There. Okay, this is your pitch curve over here, and what he's saying to do, which I absolutely agree with, excuse me, at your low position, your lowest pitch is actually going to be 48%. You've got 49%, so it's just a little higher. Then you've got 50%, that's just a little higher. Then you go to 75%, then you go to 100%. So what this here is going to give you is when you're starting your spool up from your 0 to 30% to 65% throttle, you've only got 48%, 49%, and 50% pitch. This is going to give you just a little bit of negative pitch to help hold the helicopter to the ground a little bit while the blades are spinning up. Then anything above your mid stick, three-quarter stick, and full stick, you're running 65% throttle, and you will actually control your helicopters up and down with the pitch of the blades, not the throttle. And I actually found this to be just an absolute amazing gift, because I could actually fly my helicopter, I could actually see what it was doing. I could make it do what I want. To where I was flying the helicopter wasn't flying me. So by doing it this way, I think that's a really good idea. And actually, you know, something I did find at 65% throttle on my 500. Now yours might be different because you've got the DFC head. Now my 500 is still fly barred. But something I found with mine is that when I changed my throttle curve, I still had the low position is still zero. And at my 25% stick, I think I have that at 45% now. And then my mid stick is 75, and then 75, and 75. With this here, it gave me just a little bit more head speed, and it made the helicopter a bit more stable for me. Now, it might be different for you, but you know, the cool thing is you can go into your settings, you can change it, you can play with it, and see what's going to suit you. Now, for my pitch curve in regular normal mode, my pitch curve is this over here, exactly what WC Wicked Clown suggested. So I still have 48, 49, 50, 75, and 100 on my pitch curve. So what I'm doing is from mid stick on, I'm flying my helicopter at 75% throttle the entire time, but I'm controlling the up and down with the pitch of the blades. Okay, now when you get into when you start getting into your stunt modes, and actually I've just recently got into that. Here again, this is going to be your throttle. Okay, your the stunt mode and throttle, that you want, no, you don't want that linear, excuse me. That, I believe I've got my stunt mode throttle at 95% all the way across. It's just my personal preference. I don't like running things at full all the time. I know there's tons of people that do it, and there's nothing wrong with that. But my throttle curve is 95% all the time, because that way, when I'm in stunt mode, no matter where I'm at on my stick, at low position, 25 position, 50 position, 75 position, or the high stick, I'm running 95% throttle the entire time. Okay. Now, when you get into the pitch, your pitch curve in stunt mode, let's see. I think my pitch curve, the pitch curve I have in stunt mode, that is linear. Because at 50% stick, that is actually zero pitch. And then what I've got, okay, see that right there, this is zero, and at mid stick, okay? And then here at your low position, that is, what am I trying to say here? Let's see. Yeah, when you're at your low position, you are, because I think on my helicopter, I run negative 10 degrees. It might be 11. I don't know. It's been a while since I've looked at it. But on my helicopter, I have minus 11 at low stick. And then at 25% stick, that would be half of that, so I guess that would be, 5.5 degrees pitch. And, you know, here at the middle, that is actually zero pitch. And at the 75%, at three-quarter stick, this is negative here, so this would be positive 5.5. And then at full stick, that is way up here, that would actually be the positive 11. Does that make sense? I hope it does. But you know, again, this here, this is in stunt mode. You're idle up, And you remember, the throttle curve that I use is flat 95. So in stunt mode, I'm running 95% throttle the entire time, no matter where I'm at on the stick, and I control the helicopter by the pitch. Now, something that we saw on your on your DX6i, your throttle hold. I think you had that at a linear pitch, and actually that's fine. That's what you want. And your throttle curve on hold, you want that zero, because when you flip your throttle hold switch, if you're flying around and something bad's happening, whatever, and you lose control, or I don't know, maybe your motor goes out, or just something happens and you have to hit that throttle hold, you want the motor to stop, and that way hopefully you can safely auto down. Now Delbert, you and I are a lot alike. We are not ready to do autos, but eventually we'll get there. I'm sure I will. I'm sure you will. But throttle hold, your throttle, you want that zero. You want your pitch linear at 0, 25, 50, 75, and 100. That way, when you go to zero throttle, you can bring your stick down to the lower end of your pitch curve to help bring the helicopter down to the ground, and then just before shortly before you get to the ground, that's when you can start flaring by adding positive pitch, when you start coming down to the ground, you can flare there at the end by giving positive collective, and that will slow the helicopter down and hopefully stop it. That way you can cushion it into the ground. Do you have a flight simulator? If you do, that's great. If not, you really should invest in getting one. I absolutely love mine. I've got the Phoenix simulator. I practice auto rotations all the time. For your throttle hold, your throttle is at zero, and your pitch, you want linear. I really hope this helps explain, some of the settings for a beginner, like you and I. If you change your throttle and your pitch curves to the settings that WC Wicked Clown left for you, I think that your hovering is going to be a lot more solid. I know that, the only settings that mine are different are the throttle curve in normal flight mode. I just have a little bit more RPM than what he stated here, but the rest of mine is exactly the same, I'm pretty sure. And I absolutely love the way my helicopter flies now. So, hey, Delbert, I really hope this helps you out. If you have any more other questions about, the throttle curve or the pitch curve, just ask. There are tons and tons of people in this hobby that are more than happy to help you out. I certainly don't know it all, but if you got a question, shoot it to me. I'll see what I can do to help you out. All right, man, take care. Good luck.